Welcome all. We're going to start this session about the secrets to a successful college application. And I'll start by letting the cat out of the bag. There are no secrets. This is lots of information that you have to acquire. And we are very well placed with the panel that we have here to acquire that information. As a moderator, my job is to ensure my participants speak maximally and that we have a very good chance for interaction. So I'm going to start with a simple question to each one of my panelists. In their understanding and expertise, what is a successful college application? And if there are any secrets, what are those secrets? So let me start with Anuradha. Please, Anuradha.
Thank you, Shelter. As you've just mentioned, there are no secrets, actually. It's all available online. So my first suggestion is that you should do your research really well when you're trying to start your applications for colleges. You'll have to keep your objective in mind. You'll have to keep your timing in mind. For example, we've got a panel here with the UK, American, and Australian universities here. Each country has a different timing of application. Each country has a different timing of intake. You'll have to keep that in mind. You'll have to check the entry requirements for different universities that you're aiming for. But a really important point here is that universities are quite inclusive. There are universities for each level of students, for each level of interest, for each program that you are interested in. So, if you're not getting into one university, if you think your requirements are not meeting that university's, there are a lot of universities in the world globally that you could apply to. There are different countries which look for different kind of tests. Hassan, I think, would talk about what the US would require. But in terms of Australia and UK, there are English language tests that you require, whether it's an IELTS or a TOEFL. You would also need to look at the specialized programs, such as medicines or law or architecture or some media programs. They have different entry requirements as well. Some may need you to have a portfolio. Some may need you to have different academic requirements. Some may need you to have prerequisite subjects in your class 11th and 12th. So before the panel started, I actually spoke with a few students sat here. And there is a mixed group that we've got here from class 9th onwards. So I think it's the right time that you started to inquire about what goes into making a successful application.
When it comes to making a successful application, it's not mostly about the university. In my experience, it is more about you, about what you want. For example, some of us are more interested in a location. Some of us are more interested in selecting a university that may be either private, public, or a community college. How many of us are aware of these differences? Do you know that there are private schools, public schools? Yes? No? Everybody? Do you know there are community colleges which exist? Right? It's more about what you want. And then being the right fit, that will make your application more successful. Yes, entry requirements, I would say, would come after you've selected a location or a university. Some of us are very strong on rankings or where does the university stand in terms of maybe engineering or business. Some of us are really keen on the location, right? Some of us are very keen on, okay, I just want to look at the top 20, top 30 schools. And because this is what we've been hearing for so many years from our parents, uncles, aunties, etc., right? Okay, so the most important thing for me is once you select a university, then what do I need? As Anuradha rightly said, in the US, for example, we need you to have your transcripts or academics. We need you to have SATs or ACTs. We need you to have your letters of recommendation. We need an English proficiency test from you. But there is a slight, a leeway here. There are many states in the US which are SAT or ACT optional, or many schools that are test optional, as we call them. Now, out of 4,500 higher education providers, it's very difficult for us to know even 10% of them. So the right or a successful application, according to me, is you being the right fit for the school. You knowing that I want to go to either a big school or a small school, a public school or a private school, you understanding that the next 4 years and after my degree, you know, the next 5 to 10 years would be very important.
Sure. I'll just add a couple things. So hopefully all of you are going to get into very good undergraduate schools and colleges. I'm sure of that. Looking at all of you, you guys look like serious, committed, hardworking people with good moral ethics. And that will take you all the way. I just want to say a couple things. Your GPA is going to be very important in your undergraduate degree. Unless you get a minimum of 3.0 or a 3.25, you are not going to be able to proceed to the graduate school. So GPA is very important. The second thing that's going to be very important when you get into the college, when you figure out which school you want to go to for graduate studies, that graduate studies is going to have some prerequisite courses. So for example, for computer science, it's programming languages, operating systems, data structures, couple courses. In those courses, unless you get an A or a B, right, very high passing grade, you won't be able to proceed to the graduate school. So your GPA is important, and on those key courses, an A or a B is a must have, okay? So that's why get into the right school where you can succeed, because it's not just the college, think about the next step too. So those are the two things I wanted to share with you.